Hello, I'm Rob Halim with your Asian session preview for Thursday, March the 4th, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. It's not an alert service. Currency coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of the trading day. Please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business, therefore prior to live trading, please ensure you have a successful track record using your broker's demo account. Okay guys, looks like we're getting our continuation of temporary USD weakness, which isn't surprising. We've been discussing over the course of the last week the potential turnaround on the euro, and that continues. Now check out the pound here. Same thing, different pair. I'm just going to highlight the visual support line. We've raced at a great rate of knots down to here, and we've touched this line here, which is the support when we joined the lows of 2009. Okay, early 2009, even 2000, a little bit into 2008 through here, 2009. Well, 2010. You join those dots up and we've found an area of support. So what does that mean for us on this pound in the grand scheme of things? Well, it's a little bit the same story as the euro, just, you know, once again, different pair. If we just shoot up to the weekly real quick, you cannot help but deny that from a price action perspective, we're in a little downtrend here. Lower lows, lower highs on a weekly. In the grander scheme of things, coming off, you know, a bigger downtrend in 2008, our retracement basically in 2009 has acted, you know, as we make these lower highs. 2009 it looks like it's acted pretty much just as a retracement of this move down from 2008, and you know, now 2010. We really look like we've got a lot of this sort of going on, and want to go and tag this area down here. Back to these lows below 140 at some stage looks like a real possibility in the coming months of the year. But just bear in mind, let's just get the bigger picture, and then we'll you know, drill down from there. We're at this area that we've hit here. This is not only just what visual support, don't just think of it as support. Think of it as an area where you're going to find some buyers. People are going to be trying long here. Now, the bulls in the market, this is a perfect place to try and stage a war to the north and see if you can get some upside for a while. And you know, I think that's fine in the context of the greater downtrend. I think something like this, pullback short, in the bigger picture, is a perfect way to trade this pair. Long from these parts, up around to the 158 region, up around there, then look to get short in the bigger picture. No problem with that whatsoever, and that's what the longer term chart's suggesting, and we're already getting the shorter term. Let me just go to this 4-hour chart, the shorter term confirmation that things are rolling over and looking to head up a little bit. Here's a little trade plan we made in Asia yesterday, executed in late pre-London session going into London, but we had a fib of this rise here, touch a four hour resistance, pull back long, and target is going to be the first resistance on the daily chart, which is going to be the five EMA, and we're nearing that now, and from there, now, once we reach that 5 EMA, if we just show you on the daily chart what I mean. Running into that 5 EMA on the daily now, that's going to push the price back down, you know, I would say, as a first attempt. And if you're going to continue to get long, we're going to probably have to fib, you know, back to 150, 149.50 before we're going to get long again, okay? So that'll be probably the trade plan later on today in Asia, is hitting daily resistance, pullback of this entire rise so far over the last 3 days, and look to get long. Bear in mind, guys, we're heading into the downhill run to the end of the week, and Friday is no farm, so being Thursday, you might expect a little bit of thin market conditions, a little sideways action. Well, traders out there just pause. They're going to wait for the no farm statement before they're going to be willing to commit themselves. So just bear that in mind as well. No farms, if you think, and one thing you'll learn at boot camp is you'll always, things are going to remain in the same direction technically until something fundamentally changes it. Well, nothing like a new no farm payrolls news to push price through something like this and change the world on its head, and we have to realign the satellites and look to get look to trade plan shorter even still in the longer term. Who knows? Otherwise, you know, I think technically this is trading very, very nicely to the upside. If you know, boot campers, we cover a lot of counter trend trading. You know, when trading the trend, you generally, when you're trading the trend, if you're trading like short, you go through weeks and days of, oh, I'm just making pips, this is easy. It's when you come off this longer term support, especially when the weekly's down, the monthly chart's down, the daily's down, the 4 hours down, everything's down, and the ship's trying to turn itself around, that's when traders generally run into problems. So we really like to cover off a lot of the counter trend trading stuff, and that's what we're going through right now. Technically, it looks very good. Patient trade plans have been working to the long side, and right where we're at in this daily, just to show you on the 4 hour, don't be surprised if the 4 hour does something like this, comes down lower high, then does its move, and then we get an opportunity to go long later on a 4 hour change of reversal. Just what you're seeing here on this running into this longer term resistance, there's a good 300 pips of movement that this could potentially go through before it wants to get long again. So just be patient. Trade plan, if you're a bull, you're waiting for the pullback of the move so far. If you're a bear, there's actually nothing wrong with looking to get short around these parts. Just check this pound out here on the extreme pivots. It's reached daily, reaching the zone of extreme daily pivots already, with a daily 5 EMA. A little bit of short-term confirmation rollover there. Probably fancy yourself, that's going to get bears interested and maybe shorting back to something more significant before future longs. Okay. Good luck with the rest of the trading week, guys, and we'll catch up with you in boot camp real soon. Cheers.